Let us continue with the chapter expenditure method. All domestically produced goods and services are produced for final use, either by consumers for consumption or by producers for investment. Individuals incur expenditure, that is, need to spend money for using these goods and services. The total expenditure in a given year is called the GDP, that is, gross domestic product. The method of considering the total expenditure incurred in purchasing finished goods or services during a financial year is called the expenditure method of measuring national income. This method has been developed from the definition given by Professor Fisher. In this method, the national income is measured by summing up or by adding up the total monetary expenditure incurred on goods and services by individuals, families, firms, and government during a year. Thus, national income is equal to consumption expenditure plus investment expenditure plus government expenditure plus net export expenditure. The following things are considered while counting national income in terms of expenditure method. Four factors of monetary expenditure. The various components of final expenditure considered in national income can be divided into four parts. They are consumption expenditure. The expenditure incurred by citizens, families, and firms on consumable goods is called consumption expenditure. Expenditure done on durable goods like TV, scooter, car, etc. Perishable goods like food grains, fruits, vegetables, and services like education, medical treatment, transportation, and communication, etc. Then next is investment expenditure. It is the expenditure incurred on building a factory, plant, machinery, and necessary goods, equipment for running a business or profession, etc. Next, the government expenditure. It refers to the expenditure incurred by government on various administrative services like defense, law and order, education, etc. Consumption expenditure, investment expenditure, administrative expenditure, etc. are different types of expenditure done by central government, state government and local bodies. Now, net export expenditure, that is export minus import. It refers to the difference between exports and imports of a country during a period of 1 year. The expenditure done on importing foreign goods by citizens of country is the expenditure of the country. Similarly, our export is expenditure incurred by foreigners or the foreign citizens on domestic goods. Therefore, the difference between these two is the net export, which is included in the national income. Expenditure not considered in national income. Here, expenditure done on purchasing second-hand goods, transfer expenditure, that is transfer payment, pension, unemployment allowance, financial assistance to widows, etc. The expenditure on purchase of old shares and expenditure on use of goods of interim use are not considered in the national income. Some expenditure is incurred even when the production of goods and services is not done. This expenditure involves only transfer of monetary expenditure and so it is not considered. For example, subsidies. Difficulty in calculating national income through expenditure. The official data of people's expenditure cannot be obtained correctly and therefore it becomes difficult to calculate national income by this method. For example, a business person named Arif gives 30,000 as a salary to Milab, who works as his accountant and considers 30,000 as the expenditure incurred. Now Milab gives rupees 3,000 to Khushbu, who is his domestic helper. This becomes Milab's expenditure. Now the question arises is, what is the actual expenditure? 30,000 or 30,000 plus 3,000, that is 33,000. So even in this method, the problem of double counting arises in calculating national income.